today's video, we are going to install this Happy Model EP2 receiver into this old quad with an SP Racing F3. Excuse my workbench, it's a little messy. So, let's begin. First thing we are going to do is take the top plate clip right there. Okay. And we are going to need to determine on which UART to set the receiver and where we should put it, okay? So, because this is a ceramic antenna receiver, we need to install it on the outside of the quad because carbon fiber blocks RF. So, we are going to uninstall the old receiver like this and to bring in some silicon wire. We got this high quality silicon wire from AliExpress. This was like $20 because it's 22 AVG. You can just put any old wire into an RC quadcopter because from the vibrations it will crack. I'm gonna have to mount the receiver right here and I need to calculate the wire length really quick. So we wanna hook it up to UART3 here. I cut the four wires to the desired length. Now we are going to just peel off the end of the wire. Like this. With my nails because it's soft silicone wire. Two more to go. Okay, and one more end like this. Okay, now that we got all four wire ends cut, we are going to pre-tin the wires. Okay, so I wired up the receiver. Now we are going to mount it on the flight controller. So okay, I'm gonna assume that plus is plus 5 volts and minus is ground. So let's just connect the plus. Let's be really careful because we don't want to short anything here because I may kill the flight controller. I have put too much solder here. So I'm just gonna take my solder, we can clean. Let's go. There we go. Now we are going to solder the 5 volt wire. Let's solder it straight. We solder the 5 volt. And now the ground. We got the ground. Okay, and we are going to hook up the RX. And the TX. Okay. This is it. We hooked up all four wires. And since this is an older quad, it's got basically a SP Racing F3 and a power delivery board. But what we don't know is, does that power delivery board support forest voltage? And we do not know the answer. We are just gonna plug in our power supply to use with 3S voltage. We are going to set the power supply voltage to 12 volts. That's pretty close. And we are going to get some alligator clips and connect the drone. We plugged in the XT60. This is not an alligator clip, but anyway, you can see the receiver is working properly. Now we need to go in Betaflight. But this is a whole nother story, because F3 didn't officially support Crossfire protocol. We all know ExpressLRS uses Crossfire protocol, and they didn't support it in F3, but luckily some third parties released a version of Betaflight 4.1 with Crossfire integrated. So we are going to flash that, and we are going to flash the ESCs with BlueJay, which is the best firmware for ESCs with 8-bit MCUs. Now we are going to connect the drone to Betaflight, so let's go. As you can see, it's even using a USB to UART bridge, meaning it's such an old flight control that it doesn't have a virtual COM port. Okay, whoa. I think this isn't even Betaflight. Something tells me that is something else or multi-Wii. So, okay, there we go. So, CPU clock 72 MHz, arming disable flags, RX lost CLI, and stuff like this. Okay. Now, let's actually find a... No, I don't have an older version of Betaflight, but anyways, I'm just gonna... Betaflight 4.1 F3 Performance Edition for F3 boards, and this board is an SP Racing F3 version 1. Okay, this, let's just, okay, let's just download SP Racing F3, and this is a tricky one. Which one is it? SP Racing F3. Okay, this is tricky. Let's just search on Google. I don't know which version it is. There is a V1 and there's an Evo. Okay. This is an Evo version. No, it's not the Evo, it's the V1. Yeah. The first version of SP Racing F3. Okay, let's go. So, SP Racing F3. And we need to select the port. Protocol most likely gonna be Crossfire, but oh yeah, F3. Yeah, let's just go with this. Now what we are going to do is type BL, which means bootloader, enter, and as you can see, we have a flight control in DFU. Now we cannot detect, so we are going to load firmware locally. SP Racing F3 Crossfire Hex, and we are going to flash firmware. Also, no reboot sequence, full chip erase, and yes, it won't let me flash. Oh god,
Got to install an older version of Betaflight. Oh god.
Let's just go with 10.30. This is so annoying. I wanted to just configure it at 10.80, but I can't because it's so old. This is not. Okay, let's go with. This is quite good. Okay. I'm gonna uninstall this right away when I finish this job. What?
Oh yeah. Close. Yeah, just a regular COM port. We are just gonna just load the film, okay? Flash firmware. Okay, full chip erase, no reboot sequence. Flash on connect, full chip erase, flash firmware. What is wrong with this? It's just stuck. Where is the bootloader button? Oof, man. Where's the boot button? Yeah, let me quickly search for the boot button. There's no bootloader button. Okay. It's good that there are pads to enter the bootloader. Even though I shorted the boot pads, the flight control still isn't in bootloader. What is this?
Search for. Let's just search for. Let's see. So, oh, this is this the? Oh yeah, I shorted the wrong page. Okay, so good.
So now we are in bootloader. Oh, let's flash the firmware now. Programming successful. Oh yeah, there we go. Let's see how. Oh yeah, nice. And yeah, it runs. Yeah, SP Racing F3, as you can see. Okay, so now we are going to unjumper the boot pads. We are going to connect to the latest configurator, hopefully. This is the good one. Alright, this is the one. Still shows the USB 2R. Okay, just gonna quickly. Okay, and we got this working finally, running on Betaflight 4.1, no arming disable flex. Okay, I should maybe go into ports and see. Yo, UART, there's basically two UARTs, which is weird, but fine. You can even disable MSP on the UART one, but I won't do this because it's stupid. This is very stupid to disable this. Okay, and now we enabled the receiver on UART 3. Yeah. Okay. And we are just gonna, we're just gonna connect the drone to the power supply.
This time I saw a USB to UART bridge was on a surprisingly recent FC. It is the FATEC F7.
So stupid, not using virtual COM port.
Connect, yeah, rig setup. Oh, Bill Haley 32, yo bro must be kidding. So he basically put Bill Haley 32 on SP Racing F3 drone. Bro, it's crazy. Imagine putting Bill Haley 32 on this stuff. What the F? Okay, so let's see what here. Bill Haley 32, connect. Yo, this is crazy. And just installed and realized it's about this. Okay, it's a 60 amps, yes, oh, that's really crazy. What? Input, one shot. Imagine using one shot on Bill Haley 32. Okay, so it's just saying, okay, and there it is, 32.7. Okay, PVM frequency, let's go up to 48 kilowatts. And like I said, there we go, PVM frequency, 48 kilowatts. Yeah, reverse, we need to be careful about the direction. We did a pretty good job. Okay, so, yeah, the VSC is 32.8. Yeah, yes, so VSC is up pretty good. So like this now, let's just take off this on it. Man, that's crazy.
Happy Model 2.4, Happy Model AP, and let's just build. Okay, so now we got the binary and I'm just gonna quickly connect to this Wi-Fi network. Yeah, let's browse.
Okay, so where's that? I'm just gonna copy the path, paste it. Okay, this is getting annoying.
And just gonna update this real quick. Okay, now we are on 2.5.1. Yeah, so now the receiver is connecting to my remote. Let's just, okay, now it connects. Eric's failsafe ESP. Telemetry recovered. And disarmed. And disarmed. And disarmed. Let's go to receiver. And disarmed. And disarmed. Okay, so I need to check again the wiring diagram, but let's just turn on the serial RX2. Maybe it's worth a try. Oh no, still nothing. So I'm just gonna swap the TX and RX wires and I'll let you know. And now it's working. Yeah, now it's working. Yeah, yeah. Pitch, pitch. Roll, roll. It's working like a charm. Thank you for watching and have a great day.